Thank you very much for the introduction. And first of all, I express my deep gratitude to organizers, particularly Professor Vodashyana and Commissioner Vodashyana for the opportunity to do a talk on such a great conference. So the title is Reality Principles in the Great Solar Spaces on the Real Line. I'll be starting with a little different topic. Just to explain what I mean about this definition, duality principle, because some people have in mind a bit different things about that. It's a terminology. So, for instance, if X be some function space or even column on measure space R mu is a measure, positive measure, with a positive homogeneous functional like a norm but not necessary, but this is homogeneous and positive, and if this M be a set of all measurable functions on measure space. And if if we fix a function g, then we can define two functionals. This functional strong, and this is a little bit weaker. So the difference is that the modulus of under the integral is inside of the integral, and here this modulus is outside. Obviously, this function is bigger than this. So duality principle used to be a characterization of the functionals of these two functionals, concentrate in the proof of such two estimates, two-sided estimates. It's not necessary to be equality here or here. But approximation is enough for our purposes. This right-hand side, F strong and F weak, it's some kind of functional expressed in terms of the space upon X. Very simple example. If X is just over X space, LP, then what this functional easily calculated is this is just the norm in the associated space P prime. There is a very important remark that if X is an ideal function space, it means that if you have element of this space and element of measure space, measurable function, which satisfies to this inequality, then G is also element of X, and between that functional, there is a very simple inequality. So then, if X is ideal, then these two functional coincide. By definition as a supremum. Then you replace this norm in the text space by this expression. Then you change the order of supremes. And here, you have just that functional F, strong F. So we find this as a this functional. And thus, the boundedness of K from X to LQ is equivalent to the boundedness of K prime from L2 prime to some space. But it is important here that, for instance, if X is a cone, say, a cone with some particular properties, a monotone function or quasi character and so on, so the left side in this sequence of calculation, it's not clear how to calculate this left side, because it is narrowed to the cone, say, of some function with special property. But the right hand side is okay, because it's normally it's a usual positive operator between the x spaces. Well, and I want to demonstrate this scheme how it works in some particular cases. For instance, let M be set of all measurable functions on half line, M plus is the set of non-negative functions, and this is a subset of non-increasing functions. And if parameter P between 0 and infinity and V is a positive non-negative measurable function, which you said we call weight, then now I want to demonstrate how to solve, find that quantity. In case when x is taken as a cone of all non-increasing functions with such finite function. Which is motivated by a norm in so-called Lorentz spaces. So when p is less than infinity, then we have such a function, and p is equal to infinity, then we have such a function. So, as I said, the cones closely related to the gamma Lorentz spaces, which was introduced in 1990 by Eric Sawyer, and then intensively studied by many mathematicians like Buchenhout, Maggie Bauer, and many others. So we restrict the weight V by the following three conditions. These are so-called non-degenerate conditions. And if we put such a definition of this is L, which is PV, and this is QV, then we can find the expression for the strong function F. In this case, it is no matter what sign here, because this cone is just consists of non-negative functions. So if P between 0 and infinity, then for this function we have the following results. When P between strictly between 1 and infinity, then this functional is equivalent with constant of equivalence depending only on parameter P to this not very simple expressions. Not very simple. Well, p between 0 and 1, then we have such equivalence. And when p is equal to 1, then we have a very simple plot. And the case p equal to infinity, then this case is also characterized, but characterization consists of some complementary construction, which I want to point out. Okay? connected with the previous theory. They follow the thought that if take some code, then a finite function space is called optimal for this code. If the code is embedded in this finite function space, and for any other one function space, which is also contained in the code key, this space x0 is smaller, included in that x. Where that one is continuous embedded. So the technique developed in the, for the Weigel theorem is allowed to find optimal spaces for that cones gamma TV. And the result is the following. If we introduce such a definition for any measurable function F, it is called sometimes envelope, decreasing envelope. Then for the norm of optimal spaces for that code, we have the following equivalence. When P between 1 and infinity, then we have this expression, where psi is that function, and when P equal to 1, then we have velocity, and when P between 0 and 1, we have again approximation from two sides. From two sides of this step. I should say that this formula was found not immediately and not very much easy. It took about 15 years to find that final expression. All right. Here also I mentioned the result for E equal to infinity. Where the measure lambda constructed from the weight Q. All right. And next part of my talk, there is a small supplement. If we take the form of so-called quasi-contained function, that means that the function increasing, but divided on t is decreasing. Then the analogous problem also was solved for these cones, for the two key cones, this one. So the result is known. And now, come to the next paragraph of our talk, to explain the similar duality principle in solid space. As you certainly know, solid space is not ideal. They have not that fine property that the modulo of function less than modulo of another function and so on. So in that case we have some particularities which make this case absolutely different from the previous one. So some definitions very well known. Say we have some interval of real line. And then for this parameter, LP is usually a space with this node. This VP on I is the set of wave functions. The only one description is that the function should be not identically zero. So we introduce the solid space on a real line, on some interval of real line, the first order, space is defined here. This selection of the function u, whose distributional derivative belongs to a lottery sum of function. With the norm, where the function is multiplied by some weight v0, and the derivative is multiplied on some weight function v1. And this is just the norm of each term from this space. So to explain things, we need three solid spaces. This one is just a collection of all absolutely continuous functions with compact supports. This one is a closure of the first one, and this one was defined before. So we have three different spaces, different solid spaces. And then we define that functional gx and strong gx on the solid spaces. Here the modulo is outside and here the modulo is inside. And but first we have to define that, that set test functions, test function g for which the integral is finite for all f from x, where x is either this space or this space or this space. Okay, so we have two functionals. Is it possible, the natural question is, this is possible to obtain for that function that they are different, essentially different, for instance, for these spaces. And as you see, they are different. And that is a big surprise, because in the case of ideal spaces, it's not possible. So, following the standard notations, we notate x prime as an associated space for x when as a norm is taken the weak functional gx, and the strong x prime is the same space with a strong function. Right. Okay. Actually, the associated spaces for Banach function space studied in many publications and monographs. But that term Banach function space is a special one. It includes some axioms, including the axiom of identity. All these spaces, by definition, ideal spaces. So there is a standard monograph for this part of mathematics, Bennett and Chartres, the first chapters of that monograph devoted to the general properties of Banach function spaces. And in particular, it is shown that these two functional equal for such spaces, and also it is shown that all the spaces are complete, reflexive, and coincide with the rules for the non-fundamental axis. But associated space for non-ideal spaces almost not studied. And we see for the solid state that they have no above properties. So we start with the strong functional G. Strong gx of g. Actually, this function is the smallest constant c in that that inequalities. This inequalities was studied before all that problematic was appeared. This is so-called three-weight Hardy inequality in some part of this. when on the left side you have the norm in the text case LQ, that that product of function F on some weight W. But if you look at this and this, you certainly may know that this one, the left hand side, is just a partial case of this one when Q is equal to 1. And the W is just that function G. So the story is following. The first important step was proved by Aristotle and Arif from professor from Kazakhstan in that work 1993, where he characterized this inequality when Q is bigger than 1. Later on, it was characterized for this zone of parameters in work of Yelena Ushakova and myself. But earlier than this application. Then Oynarov characterized this inequality in a different form. The story is that characterization of this inequality when Q is equal to 1 was not suitable to solve that problem about duality principle. Formulas was not good. So additional problem was find was to find a good formulas so that it looks like a needed function. So that particular problem for less inequality was solved in that two publications. Right? And now we stop at the moment for the following question, the relationship between that the functionals. So there are three functionals. This one, weak function of G, X of G, then if we take modulo G, and this strong function of G, X of G. So to prove the result, we need the following curious lemma. I don't know how to explain, but this lemma is just extra lemma. It's very valuable for the following result. So I stop for a moment. This lemma resembles some results from that monomer Benedict Sharpley. And actually based on the same idea to use Landau theorem about resonance in the spaces. Lemma is the following. If X be real vector space of functions from omega X to that real line, and similarly Y is real vector space of functions and what these functions X and Y supported by said norms, and we have operator T which maps X into Y. That means that this operator is defined for every element of X. If you have the following six axioms, the first one is just equality of signal for ref or for modulo f, then this is homogeneous property of operator T. This is kind of ideal property, but for positive function, not necessary sign. And then this is also quite natural property, and here is just known means that operator T is not degenerate, and if X is norm space, Lemma. And he is as the following saying, very wild. Says this theory that if GB is a direct measurable function, the weight E0 and U1 such that 1 over U1 belongs to that conjugate space LP prime locally, then these two functions are equivalent. And also these two functions are equivalent. But this equivalence this function is not greater than this one, but converse inequality has no uniform constant. That means that you have this inequality for associated space, but this inequality is valid for every time for some constant CG depending on G. That means that the collection for each this function or this function, fine, collection of functions, the same. But the functions not equivalent in uniform sets. Right. But if you take for weak functional modulo of G, then it's all right. We have this inequality for all three spaces. W0 and W2 0. All right. For the next step, we need some part of analytical by construction, which defined by the weight V0 and V0, V0 and V1. And the construction, the main step of this construction, because if you define that function delta xy, so you fix for x and y, you fix this quantity, and then you take the biggest number d, such that this integral not greater than the right hand side. Certainly, such a number d exists. Right. Well, now, for any x on the half line, we define the number dx. It's a number when this equality is satisfied. And then we define another two border functions, d plus x. We have this inequality. Then with some definitions, we have the following. And under this condition, we have the following two main properties. The first is equality for any x of these two quantities, and then we have a kind of normalized condition.
All right. Perhaps I should draw a little picture which explain so we have two non-negative weight functions, and this construction means under this property. This property is a characterization of the equality of the space W0 and W for solid space. Then they are equivalent. If not, then they are not equivalent. So under this property, we have the following picture. This is bisectrix, and then we have the upper bound and the lower bound. So for every point x, the the first property, this one, is equivalence of two integrals over function v1 in the power minus p prime, either over this interval and over this interval. This one's delta minus x, and this one is delta plus x. And delta x is the whole interval. On the whole interval, we have this equality, which means that we have a lot of such pictures when we have the property of equality of these two quantities. But to choose from the variety of that pictures just one, which we need later, we have to normalize. And this is just normalizing condition. Right? So such a linear construction was created long, long time ago, somewhere in the beginning of the 70s. Probably the first contribution was made by Professor Tatlbaev, because that his construction was used for obtaining some kind of criteria for discreteness of spectrum, Schrödinger operator. Right. And so main results for P between 0, between 1 and infinity, and we have a property. Then, for that strong function of G, we have that this strong function is equal either for space W or space W to zeros, and expressed by this integral. This is just that function, F strong, which was defined before. And it's important that this strong function is equivalent either for this space or for this space. And so the associate space x, strong x prime, is given by this definition. Well, but absolutely different picture situation for the weak function of g. To give the result, we need some additional definitions. If we know V capital 1 as such quantity and define two functional, that, I don't know how to say, G and another G, but they are a little bit different. And let me draw your attention that here module is outside. That means that G could change signs. It's different from the previous. Here, modulo G is inside, so that it's suitable only for the kind of ideal spaces. But now, the P modulo outside of the integral over G, here. And then the main result, it might be very nice, is that under the same condition on weights v not and v1, we have the following equivalence, that v functional is equivalent to the sum of these two properties. And the description of associated space x prime is given by the finiteness of this sum of two functions. All right. So for the weak functional of the space V naught, we have this equivalence, but under condition But equivalence, but the exact expression for this one is given by this one, right? And so I want to illustrate the previous result by the following quite simple example. For instance, if we take these solid spaces on top of line radio, then this space is given as before, and this space is coincide with W0 and W coincide here because let me show, because this quantity is fulfilled for that case. Yes. Right? And this over the space is described by absolutely continuous function. We have limit at origin given equal to zero and finite is of the node. But by Hardy hypothesis, this node is equivalent just the norm of derivative f prime on the left space L2. And so you have the following equivalent that f from this space, either at this stage from L2, side f, you have such an integral representation. So by that theorem, we have following equivalence for function on G strong. And for functional G weak. Here, delta of x is easy calculate. It's just space between, space between two straight lines. The upper line, and this is lower line. So you have just two straight lines around bisectors. Right? So we have these two forms. This was a strong function, or this was a weak function. Right? And as we show later, these two functions are different. So there are examples, we show that examples, when this function is finite, but this one is infinite. That's just, I would say, curious. Like do this inside. Right, the next theorem is that the description of associated space X strong and X weak. Using particular situation, we give a more simple characterization for that. If we introduce the following space, this is a space of like two space, but it's different. Then we observe that that set of acceptable function dx is just this space for the case where W0 or W. And this weak dx is much bigger space, much bigger space, when x is taken as a W in 2 zeros. And the next proposition is that if x is either this space or this space, then the strong functional is equivalent to this one. And the associated space is just this space. Let me note that this space is not complete. For Banach function space, every associated space is complete. But this one is not complete. And counter examples you can construct very easily. If you have a Cauchy sequence in this space, then that quantities converge to some function. But that limit function may have not such a representation as integral from x to infinity. That's the reason to conclude that this space is not complete. Right? And now to obtain the similar result for that V function, we define a little different space L2 when we have modulo outside. So it's this norm is weaker than the previous. And so in this case, we have that equivalence of weak function of n this quantity. And that gives the separating examples when this quantity is finite, but the previous one, this one, is infinite. And this example is given by the simple functions, is a sine of x over x in this power, where epsilon is taken from 0 to 1/2. Then this quantity, the quantity is finite, but this quantity is infinite. And there exists a function such that this function this integral is infinite for some g epsilon, for this g epsilon, and first is the inclusion is this infinite string. Okay, but taking this space, this one, we can extend the set of possible functions for constructing of associated functions. By this rule, x prime extended is the function from this space for which there exists a sequence of functions such that we have a tree. Certainly, this limit doesn't exist on the choosing of that sequence and so on. And if you put for definition of the norm in that space, this limit, then we have the following proposition. If x is this space, then x extension associated space is just this L2. And we have such a rule. If x is this one, then we have the following three conclusions. The left side included in this one, and this is included. Certainly, we have the following not equality. This two functions, the big function for G and for modulo G, not equal in general. And the example is that the function G epsilon of X. Okay. That is also possible to find the associated space to associated space. In the Butler function space theory, the second associate is coincide with the initial space. But here, surprisingly, we have such a problem. So that this space L2 prime, the social space L2, coincides with the solar space W with two zeros. Okay, and now the list of last publications. The first part of my talk, you may find references and some
side of the street.